As I sit at this empty cafe, thinking of you, I remember all those moments lost in wonder that will never.
And there she was on the kitchen floor. There was a small hole in the front of her head, and a very large hole in the back. Her brains were slowly climbing down the wall beneath her. Her legs were splayed open and her dress pulled up. Her fractured shin was ripped and bleeding, bone protruding at unnatural angles. She looked as though she were still screaming, but her throat was full of cockroach eggs, panties tight around her neck, hair a matted, bloody mess. She watched me with milky white eyes and listened with dead ears. I told her about the milkman, who looks like a weasel and quietly fantasizes about slowly pushing his letter opener into my spine. I told her about the president possessed by the devil and a lust for dead boys. I ate a Snickers bar for lunch that was full of razor blades and washed it down with contamination and tap water. It's slowly eating my insides. Cell by cell, I left her and her memories there on the kitchen tile, and went into the living room and turned on the TV, and in that blue fluorescent light of God, we're dead. Handguns warm, the room is red, the sky is always gray, and underneath the godless gray, a billion corpses pray. There's enough rat poison for us all.